This is the inside story of your glands, the little giants. And here to tell you about them is the one and only Slim Goodbody.
Hi, I'm Slim Goodbody, and I am here to guide you in learning what goes on inside you. Today, I'll help you understand about the group of cells called glands. You'll find out that deep within is a system of glands called the endocrine. You'll be learning what they do and where they are inside of you. And by the time that we are through, you'll know better why it's true. You've got a body of wondrous possibilities, undeniably fine. A body of numerous capabilities, busy all the time. So sit right back and relax. It's time to learn some brand new facts about your body of wondrous possibilities. Your body of numerous capabilities. Your body, it's a body, quite a body, such a body as mine. What makes your wonderful body work the way it does? Well, your brain and your nervous system are in control. Flashing orders back and forth, this incredible communications network is aware of the outside world and the inner world of your body. But did you know you have another incredible communication system? It's controlled by the glands, and it's called the endocrine system. Now, although the nervous system and the endocrine system are very different, they work together to keep you going. For example, when a man is shaving, his brain controls his movements, but his glands control the growth of his beard. Your brain controls what you want to do with your body, but your glands control how fast you grow. Your brain commands your body to act. But your glands help your body respond in a crisis. All this and more, because glands will pour secretions throughout you and me to control our inner chemistry. There are glands located in various parts of your body. Two very important glands are located right inside of your head. The name for these glands are the hypothalamus and the pituitary. There's a gland located in your throat, which is very important to you right now during your growing up years. The name for this gland is the thyroid. There are glands located right about here on top of your kidneys, which can help your body do amazing things. These glands are the adrenals. And then there are your sex glands, which are located in different places depending upon whether you're a boy or a girl. The name for these glands are the gonads. There are endocrine glands located throughout your body, each with a different job to do, yet they all basically work in the same way. Each is a miniature chemical factory, which has the ability to remove certain materials floating through the bloodstream and to use these materials to manufacture brand new chemical substances called hormones. Now, these hormones, which are actually chemical messengers, are then released into your bloodstream and carried throughout your body. One message could be to your heart, to pump faster. Lubba-dubba, 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 lubba-dubba. Or hormones may go to your hair follicles, telling them to grow more hair. Or the message could even be sent to another one of your glands, telling it to release its hormones. Altogether, your glands produce hundreds of hormones. These flow through your bloodstream, carrying messages to all parts of your body. And this is the fantastic communications network, your endocrine system. Let's sing a song about the endocrines today. If they could talk, what do you think they'd say?
Our job is to control and to help coordinate. And though we may be small, our role is so great. We're little giants. And now you know you have such reliance on the job that we do. Though small in size, we help organize. And the we do cannot be overemphasized.
There are billions of cells in you and me, all of them involved in such activity. Sometimes things must be speeded up, at other times slow down. And this is where the endocrines really go to town. They're little giants. They really are indeed a grand alliance, which we really need. Their special role is to be in control. And the hormones they produce can really serve this goal. Though small in size, don't be surprised that the job they do cannot be overemphasized. Deep inside your head, within your brain, is your hypothalamus. Everybody say hypothalamus. Not hippopotamus, hypothalamus. Now, what exactly does your hypothalamus do? When you hear chalk screech across a blackboard, do you get goosebumps? That's your hypothalamus at work. Are you hungry right now? Or thirsty? Do you feel hot or cold? If your answer to any of these questions is yes, then your hypothalamus is at work right this instant. Actually, your hypothalamus is pretty busy all the time. It keeps track of your body's temperature, of how much water you need, and in general, of how things are going on inside. Your hypothalamus is especially important because it's the link between your nervous system and your endocrine system. On one side is your brain, and on the other side is the most important of the endocrine glands, your pituitary. Now, this little gland is more complex than any other organ in your body except for the brain. It's the master gland of the body symphony. Your pituitary. You must understand, is quite extraordinary. It's your master gland. Attached by a stalk to the base of your brain, it's just about the size of a pea. Yet it's incredibly important, cause its hormones help regulate some of your other glands' activity. And when an aunt or an uncle you haven't seen for a while smile and say, "My, how you've grown," you have got to thank your very own pituitary growth hormone. Your pituitary really is very extraordinary. Yes, your pituitary. Your pituitary is especially important right now because it determines how fast you are growing. For example, you might be the tallest person in your class, but that doesn't mean you'll stay that way. Your pituitary might slow you down, and all the other kids would catch up. And even if you're the smallest one in your class, your pituitary could cause you to become one of the tallest.
Wow.
One of the important hormones produced by your pituitary is sent to your thyroid gland. The thyroid is located right in your throat, just below your larynx or your voice box. Now, your thyroid gland is very important because its hormone helps control metabolism. That's the rate at which your cells use the food you eat to make the energy you need. So if you get too little of this hormone, your body has a tendency to go slow, and you're very tired. But if you get too much of this hormone, then you're hyperactive. You can't sit still. You move too fast. At the front of your windpipe, by the base of your neck, there's a gland shaped like a bow tie, and it keeps a constant check on how much energy you need to perform your daily feats. Its hormones can control the speed your cells transform the food you eat. Thyroid affects your body's weight. Thyroid affects your appetite. Thyroid controls metabolism, so you feel real sad or overjoyed. Yeah! Your thyroid is a very sensitive gland. And since it doesn't work well if you're tense, worried, or poorly nourished, be sure to have fun, get lots of exercise, and eat a well-balanced diet so that your thyroid will do its job well and keep your metabolism under control. Thyroid affects your body's weight. Thyroid affects your appetite. Thyroid controls metabolism, so you feel real sad or overjoyed. And that's the job of the gland we call thyroid. Thyroid. And now, for the powerhouses of your body, your adrenal glands. There are two of them, and each one sits on top of a kidney. These adrenal glands are incredible. Together, they produce over 50 hormones. The most important one is called adrenaline, and it can help your body do amazing things. Give me an A-D-R-E-N-A-L-S. What does that spell? Adrenals. Adrenals. Each one sits on top of a kidney. Adrenals. Adrenals. These glands are powerhouses, you will see. When you're mad or very much afraid, and you really need some special aid, these glands make the adrenaline you need to give you extra power, strength, and speed. The adrenals and the other glands of your endocrine system are constantly producing and releasing their hormones into your bloodstream, communicating with each other and the rest of your body tissues. Now let's put together some of the things we know about this fantastic communications network. Imagine that there's an emergency. Your brain sends a message to your adrenal glands. They immediately pour adrenaline hormones into your bloodstream and your body responds. Your digestion slows down, your heart speeds up, and extra blood is pumped to your muscles. Your strength is increased.
Get out of here.
When the emergency is over, your glands stop releasing those hormones and your body gets back to normal. Another very important set of endocrine glands are your gonads. Another name for these are the sex glands. They're located in different places in your body depending upon whether you're a boy or a girl. Along with your hypothalamus and your pituitary, these glands can cause a man's voice to get deeper or a mother to produce milk when she's about to have a child. They can cause your body to begin growing hair, and they can start you changing into the shape you're gonna have as an adult. Remember, all of these glands are little giants. Yes, they are indeed little giants, which we really need. Though small in size, they help organize, and the job they do cannot be overemphasized. Now, even though these glands are very small, the hormones that they produce have an enormous influence on your body, on how it works and on how you feel. So take good care of yourself and eat good foods to keep these glands working properly.